Brought to you by Ladybird.
Castles, a Ladybird Audio Adventure, read by Ben Bailey Smith. Chapter 1. Sandy Toes and Talons.
Hello, adventurers. How lovely to see you. Missy and I are just enjoying a day out at the beach. Oh, yes, Missy, of course. I'm Otto, a remarkable inventor and explorer. And this is my friend Missy, the cleverest raven in the world. Ooh-wee, what a gorgeous day, Missy. Doesn't the sunshine feel lovely? The gentle sea breeze is so relaxing. Perfect conditions for a bit of fun at the seaside. And what do you think of my new swimming trunks? Pretty swish, eh? I've even got an awesome picnic stashed away in my bag. And this sandy shoreline provides just the spot for one of my favourite pastimes. A bit of good old-fashioned sandcastle building. Ah, now this takes me back to when I was just a little boy and you were just a tiny chick. The hours we spent with bucket and spade. Building sandcastles of all shapes and sizes, some with high towers and turrets pointing right up into the sky, some with wide moats of water all around the outside. Now would you look at that? Otto and Missy's fortress. Not bad, even if I do say so myself. If that's not the greatest sandcastle ever built, I don't know... No, Missy, don't fret about that. You're such a worrier at times. The water isn't even close. Plus, I've designed and built this sandcastle with strong sandy walls, sandy turrets, and sandy towers. There's no danger of it being blown over or washed away. Just imagine if it was a real castle, Missy, with knights and squires, swords and shields, kings and queens. I wonder what life in a castle would have been like. Nowadays, people just go to castles on nice days out. Hundreds of thousands of people visit some of the world's most well-known castles each year. And Britain is home to lots of amazing castles. Because of its long and war-filled history, Missy. There are over 4,000 castle sites in Britain alone. Well, there's Dover Castle, which was used right up until World War II in 1939. And Edinburgh Castle is one of the most visited in the world. Windsor Castle is home to kings and queens, while Kenilworth Castle is a medieval fortress. Then there's Tintagel Castle, with its associations to the legendary King Arthur. Oh, and there's Bolsover, Porchester, Warkworth, Dunstanborough, Carisbrook, Beeston, Midland. Of course, there are amazing castles all over the world. Himeji Castle, in Japan, is known as the White Heron Castle because of its beautiful white appearance. Many consider it one of Japan's most spectacular castles. There's Neuschwanstein Castle in Germany. It is an elaborate castle built on top of a rocky ledge. And Gyeongbokgung Palace in South Korea, which was built hundreds of years ago and was home to a dynasty. What's a dynasty? Well, Missy, it's when a powerful family rules over a country for a very long time. Castles come in handy for that. Oh yes, Missy, the Tower of London. We've been there before on another of our amazing adventures. It's home to some of your fellow ravens, remember? But castles were once busy with more than just tourists. They were important places. There's more to a castle than the gift shop. Isn't this just lovely, Missy? The sand between our toes, the sunshine on our faces. If you don't mind, I think I'll just have a bit of a lie down. Sandcastle building is tiring work, you know.
Oh, what a lovely day. So nice
Isn't this relaxing, Missy? Let's just be careful not to drift off. Missy, the tide is coming. The water has crept all the way up to the beach. Oh, goodness, quick, gather up the picnic blanket. Oh, it's got all soggy on the edges. And look, those pesky seagulls have been poking their beaks into my bag. They're making off with the sandwiches. Choo, choo, get away with you. Go on, off you go. Go, choo, choo. What's that, Missy? Oh, no. Our castle. My masterful feat of sandy architecture. It's gone. Oh, how foolish we are, Missy. How did we let ourselves fall asleep? It's a good job I put sun cream on. Otherwise, I'd be pink as well as wet. Oh, come on. Let's get away from the water before your feathers are as drenched as everything else. You know, I was dreaming about castles just now. Imagining what it would be like to cross a moat and enter a real one.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.